Early hard mode can be a scary time for a melee player, especially if you're playing in master mode. You're searching through the caves with your newly acquired beam sword, watching your world evil spread closer and closer to your home, sitting on top of your house as you drink all the pain away. Melee has to get up close and personal with enemies in order to deal damage. I mean, that's kind of his thing. The problem is that in early hard mode, everything hits harder than Mike Tyson punching a toddler. There's just not that many long-range options for early hard mode melee players. I mean, you got the beam sword, the frost brand, the chain guillotines, but even then you have to fight a mimic in order to get those, so if you're using purely melee weapons, you're gonna have a pretty tough time. The hard mode ore swords just don't have anything special to them. They can't hit enemies at long range, they do mediocre damage, and all around, they're just boring. And that's why no one uses them. You know what? That's it. Melee's useless. I can't hit enemies at long range, and all of these master mode monsters kill me in one shot. Melee is just weak in early hard mode. He just is. Is what I would say if this thing didn't exist. The Shadowflame knife is honestly the best melee weapon that I think they have ever added to this game. It is just so unbelievably good. It has almost zero problems. It is perfect. It is hot out of the oven. It is fresh. It is crisp. The only problem with this weapon is that you need to fight a goblin army in order to get it. Now, I understand why that may turn some people off from this weapon. When people see that they need to do some sort of event in order to get a weapon, they usually say something along the lines of, ha, nope. Also, along with that, the Goblin Army isn't necessarily known for having the best weapon drops in the game, but just stay with me for a second. The Shadowflame knife, when thrown, does 38 damage by default, and it inflicts Shadowflame when you hit an enemy with it. Shadowflame itself is an amazing debuff to inflict on enemies. It does 15 damage per second, and the best thing about it is that it can be combined with multiple different types of fire. You want to use a Shadowflame knife with frost armor, a fire gauntlet, and a cursed flames flask? You can 100% do that. With all of these things combined, whatever enemy you hit is going to be taking 79 damage per second. Good gracious, that's a lot. Also, along with its crazy damage output, the Shadowflame knives bounce off of enemies that you hit. So, you have the potential to hit multiple enemies with the same knife. The best example of this that I recorded was when I was chasing a clown after a blood moon and one of the knives bounced off of him and hit a very unfortunate dribbler. This aspect of the Shadowflame knife makes it really good against multiple targets. It's great against single targets, and because the knives bounce everywhere, you kill everything else around the thing you're trying to kill. Also, I forgot to mention this, the Shadowflame knife is a weapon that, you know, you throw. So you're able to keep your distance from dangerous targets while still dealing damage to them. I mean, look at this guy, he can't even reach me. And on top of all that, as if the Shadowflame knife couldn't get any better, it can provide light in dark spaces. So if you're playing on the constant seed, there's no need to worry about nighttime anymore. The Shadowflame knife is the best early hard mode melee weapon, bar none. And that's kind of a problem. Because the rest of the melee options that you can choose from are just freaking boring. They're either default swords or default yo-yos. There's nothing interesting about melee in early hard mode. For Ranger, you got the Onyx Blaster. For Mage, you got the Crystal Serpent and the Sky Fracture. For Summoner, well, to be fair, the only option that he really has is the Sanguine Staff, but still, my point stands. For melee, besides the Shadowflame Knife, none of the other weapons really stand out. There are some exceptions, obviously, but these are a way bigger pain in the butt to get than the Shadowflame knife is. And despite all of that, the Shadowflame knife absolutely does not need to be nerfed. If anything, buff these things in some capacity. Give them a cool effect like the new Excalibur has, or just something, because they need it, dude, like seriously. Anyways, with all that being said, I really hope you enjoyed this video of me gushing about the Shadowflame knife. It's a great weapon. It's one of my favorites, and honestly, if you haven't used it, I think you should use it more. Anyways, I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace out, guys.